Hey there. Are you ready for new habits to actually stick instead of starting over and over again? Well, today I'm going to share 9 simple steps for forming good habits that will last. But before we dig in, I want to invite you to subscribe and then hit that bell so you get notified every Thursday when I publish a new episode. I'm Kathy Schneider, and I have been an online entrepreneur since 2001, helping solopreneurs like yourself elevate your game with streamlined workflows and organized habits to maximize your productivity, because I am all about helping you spend more time doing the things you enjoy with the people you love and not falling into that habit, that trap that we do as entrepreneurs, where we're working every free minute of every day. All right, let's dig in. Step one, start small. Choose a habit that is easy to incorporate into your daily routine as a solopreneur. This could be as simple as spending 15 minutes each Sunday afternoon planning your week, and then 5 minutes in the morning planning your upcoming day. Step two, set a goal. Define a clear and specific goal for your new habit. For example, I'll spend 15 minutes every Sunday afternoon planning my week and 5 minutes every morning reviewing my plans for my upcoming day to increase productivity and organization. Now, that's just an example. You can set one for yourself. Step three, make a plan. I want you to create a plan for how you will achieve your goal. This could be include using a planner or a productivity app, setting reminders, or scheduling specific time each day to plan. I use and teach a combination of a digital calendar, Google Calendar is my go-to, and then a physical planner, and I use the Full Focus Planner by Michael Hyatt. In fact, I'll drop that link below this video. Step four, track your progress. Keep track of your progress towards your goal. This can help you stay motivated, and it's going to identify areas where you may need to adjust your plan. I am a big believer in tracking. In fact, I track just about everything, especially anything that I want improvement on or that is result driven. And I want to encourage you to do the same. Step five, stay consistent. Stick to your plan and make your new habit a priority as a solopreneur. Consistency is key when forming new habits. Steps one through four that I've already shared are going to help with consistency. Step six, celebrate success. Celebrate each small success along the way. This is going to help you stay motivated, and it's going to reinforce the positive changes that you're making in your business. I want to see you celebrate that 7 days, 30 days, 90 days, 6 months, a year. Those are some examples. Step seven, learn from failure. If you slip up, and you will, or miss a day, you will, don't beat yourself up. Instead, use it as a learning opportunity to identify what went wrong and how you can do better next time. You know, when I was working to develop the habit, of my morning routine, it took me over 2 years of starting over again and again before I got the streak that I have today of almost 3,000 days without ever missing a morning. That's a lot of do-overs, but I kept at it. Step eight, stay accountable. Enlist the help of a business coach or mentor to stay accountable and motivated as a solopreneur. You know, can also provide support and guidance when you need it, and you're going to need it, right? In fact, I'll share a free accountability opportunity with you after step nine. So stick with me just a bit longer, and I'll share that with you. And then step nine, adjust if needed and keep going. Don't give up. Habits take time to form. Make adjustments if needed, but keep going even when it feels difficult. Stay focused on your goal and the positive changes that you're making in your business. Now, I told you I would share that free accountability offer. I want to encourage you to join my free exclusive Facebook community. It's for high-performance solopreneurs, and inside this community, we talk about habits a lot, and it's a great place to help you with consistency for celebrating your wins, accountability, and encouragement to keep going when you're feeling, you know, that struggle come on. So you can join at kathyschneider.com/join-group. I'll drop that below the video. And remember to subscribe to my channel, because I publish a new episode every Thursday. In fact, the next one is a topic that I'm extremely passionate about. We just talked about a couple of minutes ago, and that's how to use Google Calendar to effectively maximize productivity.